Islamic finance is growing double digit in Kuwait today. Based on Central Bank of Kuwait data, the net profit of Islamic banks grew by 22.5% in 2018, compared to only about 15-16% of conventional banks. This is a testament and evidence that Islamic finance is growing faster than conventional finance. I would also like to add the fact that if you look at the whole banking sector, 40% of the assets in the banking sector are Sharia compliant, where it used to be much lower a few years back. So there's definitely momentum these days for Islamic finance, and KIB is taking part and contributing into the development of Islamic finance in Kuwait and across the region.
KIB is no stranger to technology. We are very active in part of digitizing the whole banking experience for the client, to such extent that you don't need to come to the branch anymore. There is virtual branches available for clients. In addition to our brick and mortar branches, we've hired a major Japanese company to redesign it to give you an Apple experience, sort of like going to an Apple store, which, again, you want to make bank. No one likes to go to the bank. I personally don't like that. So I think it's very important that you're with them on the mobile, on the phone, on the internet, everywhere. And in the malls, go to the kiosk. So I think, as I said earlier, this transformation strategy, our board is very adamant on it. Our CEO is driving it. And digitization is going to be a major, major contributor to our bottom line. And fintech as well, which we've heard a lot here while we're at the IMF.
Also, I'd like to add to what Jamal said. If you look at the Kuwaiti population, 70% is below 35 years old. And, you know, the young Kuwaitis would like to be connected all day long. And that's why there's more and more people, you know, we see ourselves and the young people, young generation, using their mobile phone to do all the transactions, to complete as much as they can in terms of things that they want to do without having to go to a branch or go somewhere else. It's all connected within their mobiles, basically. If you look at KIB used to have a capital adequacy ratio of 16.5. We successfully completed the issuance of additional Tier 1 capital, or what we call perpetual sukuk, of $300 million a few months back. And it was an extreme success, where we had 15 times oversubscription. That's never seen in the last few years in the region, in the Middle East region. And also, if you look at distribution of that of the sukuk, we've got 51% of the investors are international, so outside the Middle East, which is a clear testament of their confidence in our on KIB strategy, KIB capabilities, and KIB future.
And Kuwait, the country.
And the Kuwait in general. As part of 2035 new Kuwait vision, basically the government is doing a lot of infrastructure projects, between power, power, roads, transportation, healthcare, education. And we've seen a lot of these projects already being tendered or have been tendered recently. I can cite a couple of projects. Al Zour refinery project, that's a big project that Kuwait Petroleum Company Corporation is undertaking. There is a Dibdiba project, a Dibdiba solar power project, which is going to be tendered very soon. There is the Silk City, which is a major mega development that's going to take place in the next few months. So things are happening in Kuwait compared to what we're seeing in the rest of the Middle East region. How KIB is definitely very well positioned to not only to take part of these projects, but to contribute in making sure that these projects are successfully completed, in terms of arranging, structuring these transactions, advising the investors and public sector or private companies in completing successfully these projects, and it is definitely an exciting time for us, for KIB, to be part of these big infrastructure projects that's going to develop and it's going to contribute in the social welfare of Kuwait and the Kuwaiti population.
One thing concerning lower oil prices, Kuwait has the lowest extraction costs. So our budget is based on $45 per barrel vis-a-vis our neighboring countries. So that has helped us a lot. And all 10% of the oil revenues is sent to a general reserve in which it goes to the sovereign wealth fund, which they actively invest. They just most recently invested $200 million in China for part of the Silk Road that my colleague mentioned. And here they own a lot of properties as well as in the UK and globally. So we are very conservative as a country in investing and budgeting vis-a-vis oil prices, which is our main and sole income for the country.
Well, one last thing I would like to add is that KIB, as part of its business plan, it's more focused today, focused on the customer. We put our customers in the center of everything we do. Focused on the type of products and services that we'd like to offer our customers. And also we focus on our human capital. We are investing in human capital. We are targeting talents from the market. We are offering them workshops, trainings to make sure that these talents and the environments where they can flourish, they can give more and more to contribute in KIB development and KIB growth going forward. So. It's about focus. It's about focusing on the customer. It's about turnaround time. We manage on reducing our turnaround time, and it's about also meeting the customer requirements. That means that we have to provide a service, a product that is sometimes customized, personalized, and that's what makes the difference between KIB and some of other banks in the market.